This is good for 2 hours and 40 minutes, so we should have it down by then.
I would hope so.
So I'm going to film this little board that you screw in that keeps the boards from sliding out. But you... So here's the view from the top. And you can see the very top ladder, you can take a tie down so you don't have to worry about it kicking off. So that's like a pretty good idea, I think. Get you up to the top. And the aluminum scaff, and you can maybe see the aluminum scaff is resting on top of the ladder hooks, and I think that helps distribute the pressure so it doesn't hurt the ridge vent. And you can also see that we have the aluminum scaff with a tie down over against the Home Depot scaffolding. We're lucky enough on this roof that one half of the roof has a dormer, so the part I'm standing on isn't very steep, and then we've got a pretty steep pitch over here. But again, you can see that the aluminum scaff fits actually perfectly in between the sides of the ladder, and then you can have the ladder hooks in the center of the rung, or towards the center of the rung, that this thing can rest on. Then on this side of the house, we've got scaffolding just a couple levels high to get up to the side. But it allowed us access to replace all these rake boards and to get new paint on the highest part of the house. And here's a look at how that aluminum scaff fits nicely between the two sides of the ladder, and then you can rest it right on those ladder hooks. So that's that. When we disassemble the aluminum scaff, we'll probably be putting it through that opening right there. And those two boards that you see down there, the aluminum scaff is going to rest on those. So we have it, those boards secured so they can't possibly slide towards the street, because the pressure of the aluminum scaff is going to be wanting to make them slide out.
Thank you.